Thank you. I have four children, and that's the only thing that seems to work. The good news is there's a lot of excitement in the room, and we're grateful for that. My name's Mike Reardon. I'm the director of the Catholic Schools Foundation and the Inner City Scholarship Fund. And on behalf of our Board of Trustees and our dinner chair this evening, Brian Moynihan, it's my pleasure to welcome you to the 26th Annual Inner City Scholarship Fund Dinner. Our first dinner began because Jim Coppersmith, the then GM at Channel 5, WCVB, was down in New York. And he saw a dinner like this, and he saw the opportunity to make a difference here in Boston. And we're thrilled that Heather Unruh is with us tonight to be our MC, continuing that legacy of Channel 5. So Heather, thanks for being here. We also would like there to be a 27th, a 28th, and a 29th annual dinner. So that requires that we're done by 9 o'clock. There's additional pressure to that because our honoree this year, Ted Kelly, made it clear to me when he was dinner chair that there were two rules. Kelly rule number one, no black tie. Kelly rule number two, we're out by 9 o'clock. So Ted, we're going to make that work tonight. Tonight as you came in, you met a lot of students along the way. You saw the students and the teachers. You saw the work that they were doing. You make that possible. You'll hear from some students tonight. Know that we're grateful to you, that they're grateful to you, that you're changing lives. Now, to help us stay on time, please enjoy your salads prior to any invocation. Cardinal Sean wanted me to let you know that he normally does our invocation, but he was called to Rome to be with Pope Francis, yet he is coming back right now, and he will be here later to present the Carolyn and Peter Lynch Award. Tonight, as we celebrate, we also remember. We remember two great friends to the Inner City Scholarship Fund, Carolyn Lynch and Tom Stenberg. Both Carolyn and Tom were committed to our work. Carolyn, through her efforts with the Lynch Foundation, touched many thousands of lives and organizations throughout Massachusetts and this nation. Her loss is profound. But I think one of the greatest supports and efforts that Carolyn ever did for Catholic education was in her love and support of Peter, as he tirelessly calls and supports these students and families. Peter, you and Carolyn are a true example to all of us. Thank you, and we remember her tonight. Although Carolyn and Tom are deeply missed, they're present with us tonight. They're present in the ICSF scholars, because in those scholars, we see hope, we see opportunity, we see potential. We see the legacy of Tom, and we see the legacy of Carolyn. We see your generous support coming to fruition. Thank you for all you make possible. We're grateful to you, and we hope you see that tonight. It's now my pleasure to introduce Monsignor Francis Kelly, pastor of Sacred Heart Parish in Roslindale, to offer this evening's invocation. Monsignor Kelly.
As we begin this evening, since last we gathered a year ago, we have lost a few friends. We want to remember them. I speak of Carolyn Lynch, Peter's wife, and also Tom Stenberg, a long and generous advocate for our work of Catholic education. I'd ask just a moment of silence in remembrance of both of these people tonight. A number of years ago, I was celebrating Mass in Roslindale at Sacred Heart for Catholic Schools Week. I began the homily reflecting on this text from Luke, Luke said in the gospel that Jesus went to Nazareth, where he had been brought up. And on the Sabbath, he went to the synagogue, as was his custom. And he stood up to read from the prophet Isaiah. When I finished reading the gospel, I said to the congregation, "Who taught Jesus to read?" Now, reading wasn't very common at the time. Who would have taught Jesus? The wealthy, the important, they learned to read. So I wondered, who taught Jesus to read? And there was a quiet for a moment. Nobody answered my question. And finally, from the back of the church came a very strong voice that said, "Sister St. Rose did it." And we all broke out into laughter. Sister St. Rose had taught at Sacred Heart for probably 1,000 years. And she taught everybody in Rosendale how to read. Every Catholic school has a Sister St. Rose. Rose has died and gone home to the Lord. But she and many, many people, many women, some men, have done that work. And I wanted to pay attention in our prayer and invocation tonight to our teachers, to the people who have carried this mission of Catholic education over the years. Each of these teachers, they taught Jesus how to read. They do that every day. The faculties we have, teachers and principals, they are our major resource. They are the major asset that any Catholic school has. They are the treasure of Catholic education. Day in and day out, year in and year out, these men and these women are teaching our children. We gather tonight in order to raise a good deal of money to give children an opportunity to come to our schools to learn. Thank you for all of your generous support tonight and all through the year to Catholic education. But for this moment tonight, I think, as I reflect and all of us reflect on what we're doing, offer a prayer, a thanks prayer, for these wonderful and professional people who are teaching in our schools. Most teachers and principals, they're not clergy. They're not religious men or women anymore. This is the new world of Catholic education. And we're having to find the money, the resources, the motivation, the idealism to teach in our schools, to continue this great work. We're in the midst of that transformation that's going on. These people are teaching Jesus to read again. They teach him to read, to write, to calculate, to paint, to sing, to think, to work together, to write code, to pray, to reflect, to ponder, and to learn how to serve other people. These men and women, these teachers, they are our major asset. Without them, we have nothing. They teach in our schools. The quality of our schools, it is determined by these teachers, by their generosity, their talents, and their learning. Let me finish with a few observations from the book of Proverbs. Their teaching, it is a light and a correction and an instruction. They are the way to life, these teachers. Their wise teaching, it is a fountain of life, turning a person from the snares of death. Their teaching instructs us to be honest, to speak the truth, Tonight, may we give thanks for these men and women who teach our people, our young people, with their generosity and their idealism, for they bless the work we undertake that we want to support. We give thanks for them among us. Amen.
Well, good evening. We've got a great program for you tonight. I'm Heather Unruh from WCVB, and it's great to be back with you again. It's been a year, and I'd forgotten how incredibly large and enthusiastic this crowd is. So I'm so happy to be here with you. And I know you all are happy to be here as well. Last year was my first dinner here with you, but it is not a first for WCVB. This is the station's 25th dinner that we're a part of. And we are so incredibly proud of our relationship with the Inner City Scholarship Fund. And it's in that spirit that I welcome you this evening and tell you I'm so honored to be in this room with you. What I love, and I know you love about this event, is the children. That great handshake and those hopeful eyes and the way that they smile at you and the stories that you will hear about them tonight. It's really all about the students. It's about their families. And I think in being here this evening, you will get a real sense of hope, hope for the future, and the importance of the work that's being done. So I just wanted to say welcome to you and let you have a few bites and enjoy the company at your table. I know I haven't had a chance to say hello to many of you. I saw the Reading crowd when I came in. But hello to the rest of you this evening. I'll be back after dinner. And after dinner, you will hear from parents, and you will hear from a student as well. But as you enjoy your dinner this evening, I want to just start things off on a real high note and introduce Our Lady of Perpetual Help Mission Grammar School STEP team. And they are here to showcase their incredible talents for you. So ladies and gentlemen, the Mission STEP team.
Thank you. How about that? Wow. I feel like we should all be stomping our feet instead of applauding them. They were that fantastic. Enjoy your dinner. Enjoy the company. We'll be back after dinner. The Mission Step team.
Your line is busy, all that buzzing makes me dizzy. Couldn't count on all my fingers, all the dates you had with swingers. Boy, bye. Boy, baby, I'm gonna kiss you goodbye and go right through that doorway. So stare at the back of my head. If you write a letter to me, my former friend, don't you end with an RSVP. I'm going bye-bye. I'm moving. Tomorrow I may be splitting to Britain or Norway.
out and eating boot me bang me in. This is the end of the racket. Dance.
I say I'll move the mountains, and I'll move the mountains if he wants them out of the way. Crazy he calls me, sure I'm crazy, crazy in love I'd say. I say I'll go through fire, and I'll go through fire as he wants it, so it will be. Crazy he calls me, sure I'm crazy, crazy in love, you see. Like the wind that shakes the bough, he moves me with a smile. The difficult I'll do right now, the impossible will take a little while. I say I'll care forever, and I mean forever, if I have to hold up the sky. Crazy he calls me, sure I'm crazy, crazy in love am I. Like the wind that shakes the bough, he moves me with a smile. The difficult I'll do right now, the impossible will take a little while. I say I'll care forever, and I mean forever, if I have to hold up the sky. Crazy he calls me, sure I'm crazy, crazy in love am I. Thank you.